In this video, I'll show you how to buy any coin on Solana using the native method. I'll use Trump coin as an example because it has shown incredible growth. But remember that trading meme coins carries a high risk, so this is not financial advice, it's just a tutorial. First, you need to find the contract address of the token you want to buy. Here it is. It's important to have the correct contract address because there are many scams, and you need to be sure of exactly what you are buying. Copy it. Open Dexscreener, a platform that tracks token prices, trading volume, and on-chain trades. Go over here to the search box, paste the Trump coin contract address. You'll see a list of available DEXs, decentralized exchanges, where you can buy or sell the token. Take a look here. This is a Trump token contract address, so you can be sure it is not a scam. Go over here. You can see the blockchain, which is Solana. Next, you'll find the name of the DEX, which in this case is Meteora. The next one shows Solana and Raydium, with a trading pair Trump Sol. Again, you'll see Meteora, again Raydium, and so on. You can check all the available liquidity pools here, which are used for trading on DEXs. Let's select the first Trump USDC pair on Meteora. Here you can find all the key information about the token, such as its price, liquidity amount, FDV, fully diluted value, and market capitalization. At the bottom, you can see all the trading orders within this trading pair on the selected DEX, Meteora in our case. Now let's open this Trump USDC liquidity pool on the Meteora DEX by clicking on this icon. We need to wait a bit, but currently the platform might be overloaded due to the high demand for Solana tokens, especially Trump coin. It seems like it might be better to search for another DEX. Let's go back to Dexscreener. And this time I'm gonna open the same trading pair, Trump USDC, but on Raydium. Open it on Raydium. Agree to the terms. Let's assume we wanna buy one Trump, which will cost 0.23 Solana. But if you have USDC and want to buy Trump tokens using it, you need to select USDC here. Now you can see the price in USDC, which is 65. Another popular decentralized exchange, perhaps the most popular, is Jupiter. Let's select Trump here and enter 1 into this field. We'll have to pay 65 USDC. Take a look here. Jupiter uses Raydium's liquidity pool to execute the swap. Let's change the payment method to Solana. Jupiter will now use two markets to complete the swap. First, it will swap Solana to USDT and then USDT to Trump on Raydium. Oh, look, it has now switched to USDC on Orca. This means Jupiter is constantly searching for the best possible option for us. Okay, next we want to proceed with the swap. To do that, we need to connect a wallet. Here is a list of available wallets. The most popular wallet on Solana is Phantom Wallet. If you don't have it yet, you need to install it. Simply Google it, add it to Chrome, or install the mobile app if you prefer to use a smartphone. Phantom has been added. I'll show you how to create a new wallet. Here you need to choose whether to continue with an email or a seed phrase. I always use the seed phrase option because I believe it is safer, Next, create your password and click Continue. This is an important step. You need to save your secret recovery phrase and write it down somewhere safe. If you lose it, you won't be able to restore your wallet. Once you have saved it, click I saved my secret recovery phrase, then click Continue. Now you can open your Phantom wallet and view your balances. As you can see, I currently have zero everywhere. If you also don't have any Solana Sol in your wallet, you'll need to top it up. Let's open Binance. Register and log in to your account. Go over here and open your spot account. I currently have 11 Solana in my balance, along with 2700 USDT. If you don't have Solana, you'll need to buy it. Because in order to trade on decentralized exchanges, DEXs, on the Solana blockchain, you must pay transaction fees using Sol. To buy Solana, click Convert. Here you need to find and select Sol. Enter the amount you want to buy, let's say 1 Sol. Click Preview. Here you can see the amount of USDT required to make the purchase, along with the current Sol exchange rate. I'm not gonna buy it because I already have it in my balance. But I don't have any USDC, so I need to buy some. Click Convert again, select USDC. I'm gonna sell 100 USDT. Click Preview. I'll get 99.83 USDC in return. Success. I'll close this pop-up and reload the page. Now I can see my USDC balance. I have slightly more because I already had around 1 USDC in my balance before. Now I'll show you how to transfer Solana from Binance to Phantom Wallet. You can open Solana, then click Receive. Copy your Solana address. On Binance, go over here and click Withdraw. Paste your Solana address into this field. The Solana network is auto-matched, but if not, you need to choose it manually. I'm going to withdraw 0.5 Sol. Binance charges a 0.01 Sol fee, which is relatively high. You can compare this fee with other exchanges to see if you can find a cheaper withdrawal option. Click Withdraw, but make sure the address and network are correct. Once you send it, there is no way to cancel the transaction. To double check, open your Phantom wallet again, click Receive, select Solana, and compare the address. If everything matches, go ahead and click Continue. Then complete the verification process. Awaiting approval. My transaction is processing. And it usually takes about a minute, but sometimes 5 or even 10 minutes if the Solana network is busy. Reload the page from time to time. My withdrawal is completed. Let's check it in the Phantom wallet. Now I have 0.49 Sol in my balance. This amount is enough to trade any cryptocurrency on the Solana network. But I also want to show you how to buy using stablecoins. So I'll show you how to transfer USDC in Phantom wallet. If you try to search for USDC in your wallet, you will not be able to see it by default. All you need to do is simply click Receive. Copy your Solana address again. Go to Binance. On Binance, select USDC coin. Enter the same Solana address you used earlier. I'm gonna withdraw 100 USDC. with a withdrawal fee of 3 USDC. Withdraw. Check your withdrawal info. Continue. Pass the verification. Awaiting approval. Just wait until the transaction gets processed. Reload the page. Done. Open your Phantom wallet. Now I can see 97 USDC in my balance. Next, open Raydium. Connect your Phantom wallet. Click Connect. The Phantom wallet is connected. Now I'll buy one Trump token. I need to pay 0.24 SOL. I'm gonna click swap. This transaction reverted during simulation. Funds may be lost if submitted. I think it's happening again due to high network load. Let's use Jupiter instead, as it suggests the best options for swapping crypto on Solana. One Trump. Connect wallet. Select Phantom. Connect. Click swap. Here we are. But the network fees are elevated due to the congestion, showing a fee of 0.01 SOL. Let's cancel this transaction and try using USDC instead of SOL. Now everything is working perfectly. I need to pay 0.00204 SOL plus an additional 0.00218 SOL for the network fee. And I'll pay around 67 USDC for one official Trump token. Confirm. Transactions confirmed. Let's open the Phantom wallet to check the balance change. I paid a total of 0.004 SOL in fees. Now I have one Trump coin and 29 USDC left in my balance, meaning I have spent 67.67 USDC. At the beginning of this video, I mentioned that this is the native way to buy crypto. I say this because now I have actually bought a real crypto token. When you hold your crypto on a centralized exchange like Binance, you don't truly own it. You are just seeing numbers on a screen. If something bad happens to the exchange, there is a high chance you could lose your assets. On the other hand, if you hold crypto in wallets like Phantom, you actually own the real crypto token. By the way, if you want to withdraw your coin, just click on it, then click send, and paste the recipient's address. Make sure it's an address on the Solana network. Don't forget to subscribe if you found value in today's video. Feel free to ask any questions in the comments below. Thanks for watching!